nothing sadder than drunk men in suits. Way too many pockets. I'm walking, getting closer to my house. And what I don't know, I was wearing a necktie. And the wind grabbed the front part, the fat part of my tie, and threw it over my shoulder, leaving me with that little tie. I was so drunk, I looked down and thought, oh my God, I'm huge. How am I ever gonna fit in my little house? I'm gonna have to live outside now. There's really, truly nothing sadder than a man drunk coming home, and there's the old lady in the house. And when I say old lady, women, don't get all pissy. I'm her old man, so please don't form a giant woman and come up here and attack me. I've always had that fear of women. If you piss off more than five, they morph into a big one and just come at you. Men all over the world, man, we stand outside of our homes drunk, auditioning to get in. There's nothing sadder standing outside of your house at 3 o'clock in the morning, practicing the word hello. Hello. Howdy. Oh, don't say howdy, you stupid bastard. Only drunk people say howdy. Might as well jump through a window and kick her in the crotch if you're gonna say howdy. I've been coming out here for years now, so now when I get drunk, I just get this bullshit Englishy sounding accent, because to me it sounds more theatrical than pissed. Hello? Hello, my love, I'm home. Hello? Richard Burton coming home. Martha, come running at me, your melons bobbling, your kimono flying. Then I do her voice. That's how men impersonate women, by the way. All women, moms, sisters, girlfriends, wives, doesn't matter. Which is fair, because when women impersonate men, they always use that idiot voice, you know? Then he said, give me a break. You're not different. You're not different. You're the same. You're the same. All of you vagina people. Or women, as you prefer to be called. No. Your beauty alone intoxicates me. And I sleep in a bush. I've been with her now 24 years now. And I'll tell you one thing, man, it's not love. Love is fleeting, but spite, that stays. I'm not leaving her, that would make her happy. I'm in it for the long haul, man. 24 years with the same woman, and I'll be honest with you, ladies and gentlemen, I wake up every morning of my life, and I walk down the stairs, and I think, you know, I'm gonna kill her today. I'm gonna sneak up behind her and hit her in the head with a shovel. She won't see it. And I know she's walking down the stairs behind me. Every day, I'm gonna push him. Push this fat bastard down the stairs. He never picks up his shit. I'm gonna put a screwdriver in his eye. I'm gonna let him rot, then we circle each other. In the kitchen, spitting fire and hate. And then we have tea and toast, and everything's better. And that's why breakfast is the most important meal of the day.